In this video, we'll introduce the 32110 backup strategy and show how to quickly set it up using ActiveProtect. You can find the timestamps for each section in the video description. The 32110 rule is a key principle of data protection. It calls for three copies of your data on two types of media, one copy stored off-site, another kept offline or immutable, and zero errors confirmed through regular verification. This layered approach keeps your data safe and recoverable at all times. The 3-2-1 part of this rule is the foundation of every effective backup plan. Let's see how ActiveProtect applies it in action. Meeting the 3-2-1 rule means keeping your backup copies on separate devices and in different locations. Here, data from your production environment is first backed up to an ActiveProtect appliance, then create copies to a backup copy server. To complete the strategy, this backup copy server must be deployed off-site. This ensures that your data remains safe and recoverable, even if your main site encounters a disaster. With this setup, you've successfully met the 3-2-1 rule. But that alone isn't enough. Originally designed for disaster recovery, the 3-2-1 rule doesn't fully address the growing threat of cyber attacks. That's why our strategy now includes offline or immutable backups, along with zero error checks, to deliver strong protection. Let's start with 1 in the 1CO rule. ActiveProtect provides built-in immutable protection using worm technology. Once data is written, it is programmatically locked and cannot be altered or deleted, even by an administrator, a ransomware attack, or even a system reset. Besides immutability, ActiveProtect features a smart air gap that keeps backup copies safely offline. During scheduled backups, the system tracks data transfer in real time and disconnects as soon as the backup is done, reducing exposure to ransomware threats. However, even with these layers of protection, a backup is only useful if it can be restored. That's why the final part of the strategy focuses on achieving zero errors. ActiveProtect safeguards your backups with multiple verification methods, starting with data integrity at the storage level. It uses the BTRF's file system to detect corruption and RAID for automatic self-healing, keeping your backup safe and ready to restore. Next, ActiveProtect performs automated backup verification. After each backup, it boots the VM in an isolated environment and records the process, providing video proof that your system can be fully restored. Finally, ActiveProtect lets you run restoration drills. You can instantly boot a backup in a secure sandbox to validate your disaster recovery plan without affecting your production environment. Let's summarize how ActiveProtect implements the 3-2-1-1-0 strategy. You have three copies stored on two different media, including one offsite. Immutable and air-gapped backups protect against threats, while multi-layered verification keeps your data fully recoverable with no errors. Now we'll show you how to configure ActiveProtect to meet the 3-2-1-1-0 rule. In ActiveProtect, this is all managed through a protection plan. A single plan lets you set the schedule, retention, and enable essential features like immutability and off-site copies, making it easy to meet your backup requirements. Before we create a protection plan, there's one more thing we need to do. In this demo, we're currently on the management server, which is used as the backup copy server. So we need to add in another server for primary backups first. Go to the Site Management page and open Site Settings. Click Setup and select Add a Backup Server. The system will generate a connection key. Copy this key to the new server to create the connection. Then verify the deployment on your main server. With our backup copy server in place, let's create a protection plan. On the Protection Plans page, select Physical and Virtual Machines. Choose Immutable Protection Plan as the type and give it a name. Now let's configure a retention period and custom schedule. After that, we recommend enabling backup verification, which automatically starts the backed up VM and records the process. This ensures your backups are complete and recoverable. Finally, enable backup copies and select our offsite server as the destination. Once you confirm the settings, the protection plan is ready to use. The next step is to apply it to a workload. Let's use a VM as an example. From the Virtual Machines page, click Add, since the hypervisor is already configured. Select a backup method and server. Choose the target VM. And apply our protection plan. After confirming the settings, the system will start backing up the VM according to the plan. Once the backup completes, you can see that the backup copies are replicated to the offsite server and protected by immutability, ensuring they cannot be modified or deleted. Besides immutability locks, it's important to keep backup copies offline. ActiveProtect offers an air gap feature that automatically takes the backup copy server offline whenever it's idle. Here's how to set it up. Go to Infrastructure, then Backup Servers, and select the backup copy server. Open the Air Gap tab, where you'll configure access mode, which controls how the server isolates itself, and access period, which sets the schedule. We recommend using hardened mode for access mode. During the access window, the data port is open only for active backup transfers and closes immediately after, protecting the server from unnecessary network exposure. For the access period, we'll set a 3-hour access window each day. To learn more about the modes and calculating the ideal window, you can check the video link above. Once saved, the system automates the process. The backup copy server will disconnect after each task, keeping it offline and secure. Finally, let's verify that our backup copies are complete and can be successfully restored. Since backup verification is enabled in the protection plan, a boot process video is available. From the VM's versions page, download the video to confirm the VM starts correctly. For a complete check, we'll perform a restoration drill in a sandbox. Open the recovery portal, select a backup version, and click Restore to Virtual Machine. In this drill, we'll use our offsite backup copy as the source. Next, select Restore to Built-in Hypervisor for a fast, isolated test that won't affect the production environment. We'll use the default settings for the VM, so simply confirm them and start the restore. You can monitor progress by clicking View. When the VM shows ready to migrate, it has booted successfully and is ready for a full system check. This completes the full 32110 configuration. With these steps, ActiveProtect makes it easy to implement a comprehensive data protection strategy, strengthening your organization's security and resilience. Learn more about ActiveProtect in our other videos, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for the latest updates.